Good day to you all, and welcome back to The Murder of Sonic. We've just gotten into the library with our pals, Vex and Espio, and yeah, we'll start with the ever classic, the bin. Something's always hidden in the trash, let's check there.
I hate to say it, but there's nothing here.
Ugh, I really thought there'd be something.
Big Fids, are you sad there was nothing in the trash bin?
No, I'm alright. I'm okay. I won't cry. I'm fine.
I'm sure there'll be something hidden in the next trash bin we find. Maybe some trash, lost hopes or dreams.
You really think so? You're the best, Tails.
Yeah, we just gotta stay optimistic.
Yeah, okay. These trash bins hide a secret, I'm sure of it.
Big Fids, you're pretty unconventional, but I like that.
Was that supposed to be a compliment?
Yes, it was.
Oh, let's try this.
Let's take a pause and sit for a second.
These chairs are very comfy, so plush. It puts me right in the mood to read.
Makes me want to take a nap, personally.
In fact, maybe I'll just smash through it.
Big Fids, no. Bad. Don't fall asleep. There's been a murder, remember?
If I had a ring for every time a murderer ruined my nap time, I'd have two rings. It's not much, but it's weird that it happened twice.
What you gonna say, Vex?
Did you bring me any meat to chop? I may be a butcher, but they confiscated my meat cleaver before getting on the train for some weird reason.
You actually tried bringing a knife on the train?
Well, yeah, I got a murder somehow. I'm a man of authenticity, Tails. Without a knife, I'm just a chef in a ketchup-stained apron, not a butcher.
I think if you had a knife on you, we'd definitely think you were the murderer.
But what if I hid the knife? Say, in a body, deep within.
You know, I'm not the biggest fan of this line of thought.
Yes, let's take their order.
Oh yes, I'm starved.
Actually, I'm off duty at the moment. The murder mystery is more important.
Then why would you ask to show me the menu?
Come on, Big Fids. Why would you tease him like that?
Anyway, I thought I could trust you. You've made a fool of me.
Look, Big Fids, you made him a fool.
Come on, Big Fids. Smooth this over. No, I'm the fool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I smooth things over.
But at what cost?
What was he going to say?
Did you bring me any meat to chop?
What do you got to say?
I may be a butcher, but they confiscated my baby bear. Would have skipped through this.
Hiding the knife inside someone. Okay.
Nothing like cold cuts for a cold case. Let me know if you need any good butchering.
Got some books.
So many books on the ground. I wish we had time to pick them all up.
I sadly have no interest in picking up these books.
A lot of these were knocked out by the train speeding up. But Rogue...
Is it Rogue or Roge? I'll keep with Roge.
Roge pulled a lot of these out too, searching for something.
What reckless behavior. I feel sorry for the poor books. The spines are creasing. They're creasing. They're opening too far. It has to be opened at an exact 45 degree angle to avoid any damage so you can use it for the longest amount of time.
Man, this kid feels empathy for everything.
Ooh, brochures! There are travel destination IDs here, like amusement parks, caverns?
I was about to say caravans.
Caverns, hotels, restaurants, ooh! Bigfoots, look at this, there's a couple maps here. This seems to be a map of the library car. The books are categorized by genre, which are listed here.
Okay, I just kept reading at his house. There seems to be a map of the library car. The books are categorized by genre, which are listed here.
I love a good overhead map. Let's take it.
Library map added to your inventory.
Should we take the brochure about a cave too? Look, there's stalactites.
Nah, leave it.
Oh, yeah, that's fair. Nobody shares my fondness for caves. I'm so alone.
There's our boss. Easter egg and...
Ooh.
A chow hangs precariously from a tree branch. The large text below reads, "Hang in there." So profound.
Wow. I really needed to see this.
Hmm?
This little Charles hanging in there, refusing to use his wings to fly to safety because choosing the hard way is often the most rewarding. It's beautiful. If this Chow can stick to his principles and find strength, then I can too.
There's no way there was that much thought put into this poster. Right? The doorway out, and... Oop, what's this book? What's this bright red book?
Oh, yuck. This reeks of evil scientist Dr. Eggman. Yep, this is Dr. Eggman's autobiography and recipe book.
What kind of recipes?
Who cares? I wouldn't trust any book he's written. It's weird this is even here.
Maybe people just appreciate an omelette.
You may not be wrong.
And gloop.
I glow with our marvelous planet.
I haven't traveled around much. The islands are fun and all, but I'd love to visit some of the countries.
They're a lot of fun, honestly. Plenty of wonderful people and shops. The food can't be beat either.
Ah, sounds perfect for a vacation. The conductor was talking about Spagonia, if you've ever been there.
I have, actually. If you're ever visiting, be sure to stop at the university and say hi to Professor Pickle. He's a real pickle. He'll tell you everything about the area and makes one scrumptious sandwich. A pickle sandwich.
I'll keep that in mind, thanks. This group knows everyone and has been everywhere, haven't they? Did the table, did Vex, Yep, just SBO now. Fancy a poem? Can I get a poem about... trains? Locomotive in motion, I think I lost my lotion. The window shows the ocean, oh wait, there's my lotion. Thanks.
I actually really like that one.
Huh? I'm gonna ask for everyone's order. Everyone's order. I have a poem about this. My starved stomach babbled, though I ignored the grumbling tummy, for the eggs I received are scrambled when I asked for my eggs, Sonny. Oh wow, we don't serve any eggs on the train though. My talent was wasted on you. Okay, I think we've got... Oh, it's the window.
Ciao, Cola. Check out our book club. Book of the month, Gone Cow.
Gone Gal. Ooh. Neat. And I think... Oh, can't forget this. Just this last bookcase.
Wow, I wish I could stop and look at all these books. But Sonic needs me. No time to rest.
All right, let's move on then.
Well, I mean, a little peek wouldn't hurt.
He's scavenging through all the book titles excitedly. He's like a kid in a candy shop, or in this case, a genius in a train library.
That's odd. I know some books have fallen out on the floor and everything, but every book in these shelves is in alphabetical order but this one.
The Mirage Express Manual.
It's the user guide to the Mirage Express, the train we're currently on.
Do you think someone found it on the ground and put it back?
Maybe, but it is interesting. Let's make a note of this.
Mirage Express Manual's been added to your inventory.
We'll interview Vex. Oh no. Forgot about the arm. Never mind. Be back in a second.
Oh, poor thing. That arm is really struggling cleaning up this car.
To be fair, I wouldn't want to clean up all this mess either. Let's just leave it alone and let it do its thing.
Yeah, probably for the best.
Okay, Vex. It's your time to shine.
I don't think we have enough evidence yet. Why don't we look around a little more first?
What is there? Okay, can we interrogate you, maybe?
I don't think we have enough...
Okay, so we've checked the books, checked all that. Should we go?
Shall I supposedly walk through the library car before going into the room? When Cheryl left the library car, he looked the rest of the way out. There's gotta be a reason he's doing this. Should we make a note of it?
Sorry, just scrambling through that because I'm just trying to figure out this car.
Yeah, I do believe we should.
Shadow's lock has been added to your inventory.
I think we've found enough clues.
Okay, that's the last thing.
Let's go interrogate Vector and Espio to find out what really happened.
Attempt number two.
So, the two of you don't believe us, eh?
Oh, you won't believe us. I'm Vector. I'm the one that's talking, not Tails.
It's not that we don't trust either of you, but I wouldn't be a proper detective without examining the validity of your alibis. Bigfoots and I are here to confirm two things. why Vector left to go play games with Knuckles, and if Espio really was reading in the library car.
Vector, we'll start with you. Why did you leave the library car to visit Knuckles? We're prepared to present evidence if...
Oh, that's easy. I got bored.
Oh.
Right.
I wasn't entertaining him enough, it seems. Vector enjoys being social.
Plus, you instructed to mingle. I remember the arcade machine in the saloon car, so I figured I'd go check it out.
This seems to line up with the information we gathered from Knuckles.
And that brings our attention to you, Espio. Rouge entered the library car, found something, then left. You said you immediately started reading, but were you actually reading the entire time you were in the library car?
Well, of course he was.
Hmm?
Once Espio starts reading, he doesn't stop till it's done. I've seen it happen.
It must have been a good read. What was the book?
Espio doesn't owe you that, detective. Let the man live. What if it was embarrassing? Like the autobiography of Dr. Eggman, The Ins and Outs of Eggs.
Well, what kind of things do you think I read?
If you won't talk, I have a hunch on what the book might be. Bigfoots, could you help me out?
Okay, Bigfoots, it's go time. What book do we think Espio may have been reading? I want the... I was hoping for the Eggman option. Oh, this one.
A manual? You think Espio was reading instructions? What argument could you possibly have to support this?
We got this. Okay, fairly simple. Nope. As soon as I said it was simple.
You're both grasping, I knew it.
Got this, Bigfoot. Let's try again.
Yeah, let's do. Jump. Okay. Yep. Let's get out of that. I didn't jump again. Okay, grasping. We got this. Third time's a charm. Okay. Stand in the middle. And gone done it. Yeah.
I had an idea.
There are books scattered around the floor, sure, but the remaining books on the shelves were all in alphabetical order. All except this manual, meaning someone, at the very least, picked up the manual and put it back in the incorrect place.
Gah.
This lack of attention to detail isn't normally like you, Espio.
Wait now, I wonder if you would enjoy my power like this.
Calm down, Vector. I know you mean well, but I can handle myself.
Oh, my apologies, Espio.
A butcher and a poet friendship can form anywhere. That is indeed the book I was reading, the Mirage Express Manual. Trains are cool. I like trains.
In that case, we'd like to ask you a few questions about the manual, Bigfoot, if you don't mind. Could you ask Espio some questions about the manual? Just flip to a page and ask away.
Oh, I see. Quiz Espio about the manual to prove you read it. Which page should I quiz him on? Some good choices. Let's go for the middle. Okay, what efficient and extremely accurate technology was installed to assist in keeping the train spotless? Robotic arms. During events, they can perform a variety of tasks and are responsible for cleaning up trash and messes afterwards. I remember the conductor saying the train can clean itself, though I have a feeling the train company just didn't want to hire any janitors.
Robots! Took my job!
The robotic arms can also detect weapons or explosives being brought onto the train, ensuring passengers' safety.
Seems like Espio aced that question, Bigfoot. Hit him with another one.
Okay, which page do I choose? Let's go with the big one. What is the Mirage Express's cancellation policy? No refunds and you will be charged a no-show fee. This does not apply if you're over the age of 65, because you could drop dead at any moment. Gee, the person who made this rule must have been over 65.
Last one, Bigfoots. Let's see if SPO can go 3 for 3.
Gotcha. Which page should I pick last? Yeah, we'll go with the earlier one. What was implemented to support the conductor duties and ease general train obligations?
An intelligent data processing system. It works in tandem with the conductor to ensure smooth travel for guests.
I remember this. The train has an autopilot, but it can't access its full suite of capabilities without the conductor present.
Now, did I pass your little test?
Yes, totally. It's wild you were able to retain all this information so quickly.
A poet's brain is often surprising.
I don't know if I'd be bragging about that.
You've clearly read the manual. Those answers feel far too specific to be guesses.
And you both had the nerve to question my buddy like that.
Don't we want to be supporting folks who can read?
You have to admit, though, reading the entire time a murder occurred does sound a bit suspicious, even if true. But he has answered all my questions so calmly. That's very impressive.
No, no, I understand everyone's cautious attitudes.
Vector was the only one to see me reading, after all. My alibi is hard to substantiate despite being the truth. Well, you definitely read through the manual, so I suppose we can...
SVO, is that true? Vector was the only one to see you reading?
Yes, that's correct, problem.
Frankly, I don't believe that can be true, and we have evidence to back it up.
Bigfoots? He always puts me on the spot.
Okay, Bigfoots, think. We should have a piece of evidence linked to someone who also saw SVO reading. But what?
Okay. Would it be... Shadow?
Shadow's lock? Please pray tell what this has to do with anything.
We're up, Bigfoots. Let's get our argument together. Thinking time.
Okay.
Gotta avoid the flying knives.
No, my rigs.
Okay. Just enough. Well, not just enough, but less than usual.
I failed. Shadows walked through the library car to get to the saloon car, where he set the original high score on the arcade machine.
Yeah, but I ended up beating it. It wasn't the high score for long. Crocs are natural gamers.
SBO said he saw Shadow enter the library car, but he's mentioned nothing about Shadow's return. He only mentions that Vector came back. When Shadow left, Knuckles and Vector in the saloon car, SBO was fully seated reading his book for a good while at this point.
Gah.
We know Shadow had to walk back through the library car when he left the saloon car. So there's absolutely no way Shadow and SBO didn't notice one another on Shadow's return trip.
It was a simple slip-up. I was just fully immersed in my book, that's right. I didn't notice Shadow.
You're telling me the sound of doors opening and locking wouldn't have caused you to look up?
Well, you see, I can sense SVO's desperation here. Defending the argument that he was reading the entire time isn't easy.
So if you didn't see Shadow returning from the saloon car to lock the doors, then at that moment, were you really in the library car at all?
But how would SVO leave? Shadow locked all the doors and no one saw SVO in the saloon car.
It's a mystery, my dear Bigfoots. One that I would love for SBO to solve.
You gotta believe me. That cool demeanor is vanishing. I was so involved with my book, I didn't know the shadow passed back through the library car. Honest. When Vector returned, he even had to tap me on the shoulder to get my attention.
Yeah, I think I remember doing that. Probably, maybe. I'll roll with it.
I must avenge my friend's death, so I'll ask you again, SBO. If you weren't here for Shadow to see you reading, then how did you leave the library car?
I didn't. Why doesn't this seem right to me? Tails definitely feels like he's onto something, but I just don't see it. Was SBO simply sitting reading, or did he somehow vanish to not notice Shadow's return to the library car? What should I do?
There's definitely something there.
I'm gonna back up Tails. No, I can't interrupt Tails while he's onto something. I'll let him continue his line of questioning and... What have we got?
Bigfoot, my favorite and beloved employee, please. Protect the passengers aboard this train. They must be taken care of. If you fail, the lawsuits will be torturous. Don't allow such an old, feeble soul to get sued, because I'll bring it back tenfold on you.
I have to make sure our guests are taken care of. I have to speak up. Tails.
Yeah?
We have a piece of evidence that can answer all of our problems. All right, my fellow associate, lay it on me. What piece of evidence shows Shadow and Espio couldn't have seen one another? Yes, we got this. All right, now let's get my thoughts in order. It's time to think thunk once again.
What?
Set aside. Not doing too well. Okay. Okay. Alright. I can live with this. I can't live with that. Ah! Alright, 60.
The library map? Oh, I see.
See the exits? They're right across from one another, a straight path. If Shadows walk down the straight path, there's a way Espio and Shadow couldn't have seen one another.
Looks like you'll have to point out exactly where on the map you mean.
Where could Espio have been for Shadow not to see him? Oh, I got it. I was clicking for next, but okay. We got a entry exit dealio straight from here. I would wanna say, cause that's straight in line with the door. See them there. I think it's this one. Interesting. That's where I was sitting, reading my book.
I can second this. When I returned from the saloon car, Espio was in the same spot.
That confirms it then. You see, Shadow and Espio couldn't have seen one another from this spot, because a bookcase is in the way.
There's no way Shadow could have seen Espio or vice versa.
It makes a lot of sense why you never mentioned Shadow's return, Espio. There's just no way you would have seen him.
I apologize for losing my cool back there. I felt like I was grasping despite telling the truth. But I'm glad you all believe me now.
Your alibi isn't the most airtight, but I have no further points. Thank you both for answering all our questions.
We did it! Another pair of alibis validated. And, oh wow, just having a look at the time, I see that with that interrogation we've gone a few minutes over. So, we will leave it here for today. Thank you for coming back to the Murder of Sonic and for the Vector and Espio episode, essentially. Well, then until next time, drink plenty of water and talk to you later. Bye.